Hey guys, it's Rick here at Leitz, and I am doing a pretty cool pedalboard build this evening. A local artist named Jessie Ritter came in, and she needed me to put some of her vocal and acoustic guitar pedals onto a single board so that she only had one place to plug in when she, you know, went from place to place while she was playing. So what I'm going to do is walk you through what I've got. I'm going to put it together. There's a couple pedals that are missing, but that's because she was gigging tonight and needed to use them. She's going to drop those by tomorrow, and then I'll finish putting it all together. But we're going to be using PedalTrain. This is a classic one. Using the True Tone One Spot CS7. Big reason for that is because this has the ability to switch to 12 volt and TC Helicon's pedals like to run off 12 volt power. So had to go with the CS7 on that, which is a nice feature on power supplies. So it's something to keep note of when you're trying to figure out which power supply is going to be best for you. You want to definitely make sure that that voltage matches. So we are putting on TC Helicon R1. It's the vocal reverb that they make. And also a TC Helicon. This is the T1. It's the adaptive tone and dynamics. So it looks like it's got some compressor, some tone shaping. Not something she uses a lot, but she likes to have it on there just in case she wants to play with it. The other TC Helicon pedal you don't see here is because she's using it as the harmonizer. So that's going to go on there. And then when it comes to guitar-wise, she's going to be using the LR Bags Venue DI. So that's going to be a large part of her acoustic guitar tone. And then also the Holy Grail by Electro-Harmonix, Neo. So basically, a lot of this is going to be fast-forwarded because you don't want to see me sit here and take an hour or two to put this together. But I'm going to start with making sure that the power supply fits. What's cool about these One Spots is they come with some brackets that are especially fit for them. You just want to make sure, you just want to make sure that when you put it into the board, you still have access to be able to plug in the IEC cable, and you want to be able to plug in your pedals. So I'm going to just make sure that it fits correctly, and if I need to modify anything, I will let you know. Here we go. So what's cool is it comes with some screws, so it comes with the silver ones that are designed to screw into the board, and then also comes black ones that will allow you to screw the pedal board attaching brackets to the power supply. It's cool. You can see that they've already pre-drilled it, so it makes it really easy to put on. You don't have to take anything off. What I really like is they give you two extra just in case you lose these little things. That's always nice and thoughtful, because they're pretty small. Yeah, this is what I'm talking about. So the brackets kind of drop it a little too far, and you can see I'm not going to be able to reach. So let's see if I can make this work. No, it always helps to read the instructions. It's supposed to work for PedalTrain, so I'm going to take that back, but I'm going to figure out this. So it says make sure the one spot Velcro is slanted during the mounting so that the IC input socket is in between the rails of the pedal train. To help position it correctly, place a 9-volt battery under the 1-spot Pro. So, got the brackets back on. Got a 9-volt battery underneath to help me angle it, which I read in the instruction manual. And that's going to allow me to get this thing positioned just right. I'm going to screw it in. Also, in the instructions, said I did not need to do any pre-drilled pilot holes. I can just drill these straight in. So, we'll give it a shot. Such liars. They are such liars. We'll be drilling pilot holes. Always drill pilot holes. It just helps. They say you don't, but you do. You just do. So they said if you're using a power screwdriver, you don't need it. And yeah, the screwdriver worked just fine. It's these cheap screws that don't. So we are gonna do this smallish pilot hole. Pilot holes drilled. Now I'm going to attach the power supply to the board. Yep. Looks good. Those match perfectly. Okay, power supply has been installed. I have access to those, and I have access to my IEC cable, so it's perfect. It's what I wanted. All right. Next step. It's Velcro time. Velcro time. Yeah, it's kind of cool. I like it. I can still get my cables through there, so. Just wipe it down. Good wipe down. Make sure there's no drill bit metal stuffs. Alright, pedal train. Loads. Sends this Velcro. It's awesome. Again, I use soft side down because it doesn't collect as much hair and lint and dirt as much as the hard side. The hook and loop, whatever it is. So we're just going to measure. I like to leave a little. I don't want it going all the way to the edge because that's easy. It starts getting caught and start pulling up. So I always usually leave about maybe a just a, like not even half an inch, maybe less than that, clearance from that to there. I'm gonna grab scissors. So for this stuff, you just want to do a little bit at a time, make sure that you're going straight. And not too big of a deal if you get off a little bit, you can always pull up and correct, but I like doing it right the first time. Super, super strong industrial grade Velcro. Yay, buckle down. All right, I'm taking off the rubber feet from this pedal. That way it will grip better. Don't have to worry about level. Tools. You know, keeping the work very clean. Take the little feet off of the Neo. right, so here we go. We're going to attach some the hard Velcro, as I like to call it, to the bottom of these pedals. I like to just use one solid strip all the way down. That way it gives me as much coverage as possible. That way whatever I can get, whatever I can get to stick to the board, it's gonna hold a little bit better. I think I'm gonna stop there for right now. We'll have the other pedals here tomorrow morning, and I'll be able to get it put together and wired up in the morning. So it should be a fun video. We'll get it tested so you can see what it sounds like when it's all hooked up. But that's the first half. Putting it on the power supply, mounting it, putting on the Velcro, and starting to Velcro the pedals. Once we get those Velcroed up on the board, then we're gonna do our cabling and our power cabling as well. So, all right, we'll resume this tomorrow. All right, we're back. Got the rest of the pedals. Let's put this thing together. You're welcome.
What?
Crazy. Big bait crazy. cleaning up underneath.